seen one of these in months. Like, I can only buy one of these. I can only get one thing of toilet paper. Oh my God, the prices. Like 18 bucks just for some toilet paper? Like, that's ridiculous. If you have like a super dark closet like I do, I got this light from the hardware store. This is it's probably just the same damn thing. Still doing this. Got a lot of questions. It's 44. I'm 127. My hair looks crazy. It's my roots. So right now I'm still working on my comprehensive case study. I actually chose a different client this time. She is a survivor of sexual assault. She was sexually assaulted at a university, and she's suffering from PTSD symptoms. I have not done the assessment yet, but based on what she's told me, like the somatic experiences that she's having, like when she's retelling her story, she can physically feel the, it was cold that day or that night, so she can still feel the cold when she's retelling her story. So that's an example of how when a person experiences trauma, that traumatic experience will pretty much like push itself into the present. So say that you're in a safe place, and however, when you're telling your story, you're mentally going back to that situation, so you end up reliving that trauma. And by reliving that trauma, I mean experiencing like the feeling that you had during that time, whether it was like really hot or really cold, or whether you smelled something. A lot of survivors will say that they remember a certain smell, and when they smell it again, they will instantly have a flashback. Taste, any of the five senses, pretty much. So with her, my plan is to first build rapport and then work on grounding techniques, coping skills, breathing techniques, and definitely a focus on progressive muscle relaxation, specifically the pelvic floor, because survivors of trauma, of sexual trauma, that's a very consistent area, has been traumatized. They can regain control by doing Kegels. It's January 2nd. My fridge does not work. So we're getting off to a good start to the new year.